government is focused on COVID, but there are plans for the future too. It wants to build back better, and it wants to build back greener. Of course you know this building, but you are unlikely to know this one. Inside number 9 Downing Street, the small team I work with is organising not only the largest political gathering that Britain has ever held, but also possibly the most crucial. By November, my colleagues, some of whom you're about to meet, have to have got more than 190 world leaders to agree nothing less than how to protect the planet.
By the way, I've timed it, it's just under 22 seconds. 22 minutes.
Is that including holding for applause at various points?
25
Let's go through.
For one, if we're being too alarmist.
Well,
I
mean,
I don't think I
don't think you can be alarmist enough, frankly. I mean, yeah. on this stuff, right? I mean, if you believe the science, then. Okay.
Alok Sharma will be president of the 26th UN Annual Conference of Parties, COP26. Every country has a voice, and the diplomacy is delicate. The Gabonese are fated for impressive reforestation. Chairing the African group, they will be crucial to COP.
Right, come on through, guys.
So how many countries have you been to since
I saw there's a map up there, and we are sticking wooden pegs into it. There's a, I think we can put another 3 in now as a result.
So Sasha, what's his diary like?
Diary today?
Just in general?
In general,
chaos.
It's absolute chaos. So for example, we've got things with Pacific Islands. There's no time that you can do it that's not first thing in the morning or last thing at night.
Yara. Lovely to see you. Really good to see you. Lovely to see you. Exactly. Exactly.
With 6 months to go, there are still serious issues on international finance. At the 2015 COP in Paris, history was made. Every country from around the world agreed to curb temperature increases to 2 degrees. Now that Paris Pact has to be put into practice at Glasgow. In the 6 years since Paris, global warming has got worse. We have a target, we aren't hitting it, and without action, it's getting further away. The numbers may be bad, but this is where it gets better. Britain is a world leader in diagnosing the problem and dealing with it. Alok has come to Whiteley, just outside Glasgow, the UK's largest onshore wind farm with 600 clean green jobs, and a new announcement of green apprenticeships for his visit today. Out of the gloom should come a jobs boom. Nonetheless, the COP26 challenge is immense. Here's my attempt at a cheat sheet. Secure global net zero means countries produce no more carbon than they remove by mid-century, but also a second nearer target, to halve emissions by 2030. If they do this, they keep 1.5 alive, the mission statement for COP26. To do this, the UK wants an end to coal power and the rescue of the rainforest. Every country demonstrates adaptation to extreme weather like flood defences or early warning systems, but these have to be paid for. The third goal. Mobilising finance. Developing countries were promised at least $100 billion a year by rich countries. Alok says it must materialise. It's a matter of trust. Number 4 is global collaboration to find technological answers to climate change and also completing the Paris Agreement. I'm the Prime Minister's COP26 spokeswoman, and over the next 6 months, I will of course be meeting delegates and negotiators, but I will also be meeting unexpected climate leaders, individuals who are making small changes to meet this big moment. And it couldn't be bigger.